80 days in which you can happily go about investigating and filing a charge sheet. This calls for, this makes the lazy investigation, lazy prosecution, and therefore laziness all around, and therefore needless incarceration. So I believe that these are some of the issues which I think needed to be flagged. I think the Honourable Law Minister is not only an eminent senior advocate, he is also a very enlightened citizen. So therefore, he will be the first to understand that many of these issues we have flagged in the right spirit. The government is doing a splendid job, I think, and that's the reason they have got, in all fairness, the kind of majority they have got is because a large chunk of people in this country felt that this government is giving them more safety. No, there's no question, I have to admit that on the floor of the House, that they feel that the government is giving them more security and safety than other governments have in the past, as a result of which you yourself, Honourable Chairperson, kept saying that the 303 figure is really a significant benchmark because of that. Good luck, but let the government therefore look at many of these issues which needed to be flagged. Thank you again very, very much.
Srimati Mahua Moitra.
Madam Chairperson, sorry, I'm late. We had a meeting with the Prime Minister, which I lost my slot, so I'm grateful for giving it to me now. I rise today in the absence of the Honourable Home Minister, for which I'm quite sad, but I hope he's listening somewhere. I rise today to vehemently oppose the UAPA Amendment Bill 2019.
MOS Home is here.
Yes, I know. I was talking about the cabinet. No problem, sir. No problem. No problem. It's okay, sir.
He's gone to Rajya Sabha. This is fine. This is members' time. Somebody has to be taking note.
I rise today to vehemently oppose the UAP Amendment Bill 2019. Please. Warren Buffett is said to have once said, if you put a police car on anyone's tail for 500 miles, they're going to get a ticket. The current dispensation at the centre seems to be following this very reasoning. If they want to target someone, they'll get them somehow, on some law or the other, on some lacuna or the other. Opposition leaders, rights activists, minorities, anyone who doesn't agree with the homogeneous idea of India that this government is trying to thrust upon us, is at risk. Agar inke saath ho to Bhagwan, na ho to Shaitan. Ye to na insafi hai. In the short time that I have been privileged to be here in this house, I have experienced it firsthand. Each time we oppose a bill, bring in a cut motion or move an amendment, and these are all purely hypothetical exercises given the brute majority this government enjoys, we run the risk of being labelled anti-national. When Dr. Tharoor opposed the introduction of the UAPA bill, no less a person than the Honourable Home Minister leaned forward and said, "Soch lijiye, virodh karna hai kya? Wapis lena hai?" The Honourable Minister sits in Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel's chair. Patel was the unifier of India. He once said, "It is the prime responsibility of every citizen to feel that this country is free and to defend its freedom is his duty." Sir, it is not enough to build the world's tallest statue in Sardar Patel's honour. We must all of us try at least to stand as tall as him. Why? Why, sir, do I feel a sense of Venice? Why, ever since I've been elected and since my maiden speech, do friends and family call me and tell me to be careful? They'll somehow get you. Why do I feel this? You've come here as a result of a popular majority. I too have been elected. All of us here too have been elected. Why are we in the opposition always at the risk of being called anti-national every time we disagree with this government on issues of national security, on issues of law and order, on issues of policing? Every time we disagree, this government, its troll armies, its propaganda machinery, work overtime to call us terrorist sympathizers, to call us secular, to call us anti-national. Madam, I urge you to put the house in order, madam.
Yes, Mr. Ahluwalia. Just 1 minute, Mr. Ahluwalia. Tell
madam,
me the rule and please read the rule.
Madam, I'm not yielding. Please let me.
No, it's not about you yielding. I have yielded to him. He's saying point of order. I have to listen to him. Get the book. Where get the rule book.
Madam,
where is the book?
Tell me which rule, sir.
No, madam, it is in the rule book.
Excuse me, I'm sitting here. Please be seated. Please be seated. I'm asking him the same question. Please be seated. I'm asking him.
When you are making allegation against government or against anybody, can you substantiate it? What you are saying,
madam,
and if you can't substantiate it, you can't make such allegations.
Madam, please.
Why? Where is the government troll machinery or army?
Madam,
I will.
What she is talking
sir,
about?
Thank you, Aluwalia ji. Let me just read it to you, ma'am.
Yes.
No allegation.
Miss Moitra,
just 1 minute, 1 minute, please. No allegation of a defamatory or incriminatory nature shall be made by a member against any person unless the member has given adequate advance notice to the speaker and also to the minister concerned, so that minister may be able to make an investigation into the matter for the purpose of a reply, provided that the speaker may at any time prohibit any member from making any such allegation if the speaker is of the opinion that such allegation is derogatory to the dignity of the House, or that no public interest is served by making such allegation. So, Ms. Moitra.
Madam.
Madam,
I can fight my case, sir. Gaurav, I can fight my case. Madam, I will fight my case. Madam, Mr. Alu. Madam, he has not set the point. He has not set the point. You have said it's fine. You have said against any person. My allegation, I have
Parliamentary Affairs
record.
Minister pointed it out. Parliamentary
point.
Affairs Minister
madam,
pointed it out.
Madam.
Just be my.
I have no, my madam.
Madam.
I have
so
not
Minister of State is the minister.
Minister.
Mr. Roy, you know it better.
Madam.
No. What are you saying?
Madam.
What kind of accusation is that supposed
madam,
to be?
Madam, this is nothing
please
but
be seated.
A ploy to
please
disturb
be seated.
My speech.
Please be seated. A minister to the government of India is a minister, and he made a point.
Madam, मैं
मैडम ही वांट्स टू स्पीक मिनिस्टर वांट्स टू
मैडम मैं ये बताना चाह रहा हूँ कि ये अब जब बोल रहे थे और जब ऑब्जर्वेशन ले रहे थे माननीय सदस्य तो इन्होंने कहा गवर्नमेंट हमेशा जो अपोजिशन है उनको एंटी नेशनल कह रही ये हमने कभी नहीं कहा जी किसी मंत्री ने नहीं कहा ना हमने कहा ये सब दिन को वापस लेना चाहिए मेरा ये सबमिशन
मैडम आई विल स्टैंड हियर मैडम जस्ट बिकॉज दे हैव 353 डज नॉट मीन दे विल शाउट अस डाउन आई स्टैंड माय ग्राउंड द ऑनरेबल मेंबर डिड नॉट कोट द पॉइंट यू कोटेड द नंबर ही डिड नॉट आई हैव नॉट मेड एनीथिंग आई हैव नॉट सेड एनीथिंग अगेंस्ट एनी सिंगल मेंबर मैडम प्लीज
कलेक्टिवली यू आर सेइंग अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट यू नॉट सेड इट अगेंस्ट वन पर्सन
आई सेड द प्रोपेगेंडा मशीनरी एंड द ट्रोल आर्मीज आई एम ऑन record. I have said it is unfortunate that you need three ministers to stand up and fight me. It is unfortunate today that you need three ministers in the treasury benches to stand up and fight me. It is unfortunate. I welcome the honorable minister. Thank you. I am sure Mr. Shah will have the grace to hear me out. I have full confidence that here he will have the grace to hear me out. It is a matter of, I would say, great shame that it needs three ministers to single-handedly handle me, but I will continue. Thank you. Because to paraphrase both the Mahatma and George Orwell, the truth is the truth even if I'm a minority of one. And in times of deceit, telling the truth is a revolutionary act. Sab tere siwa kafir, aakhir iska matlab kya? Sab tere siwa kafir, aakhir iska matlab kya? सर फिरा दे इंसान का ऐसे खत से मजहब क्या हाँ तो हमने सोच लिया विरोध हम वापस नहीं लेंगे आई विल स्टैंड हियर इन दिस हॉलोड चेंबर एंड स्पेल आउट माय ऑपोजिशन
माननीय सदस्य प्लीज एक मिनट बैठे प्लीज माननीय सदस्य ये सदन है आहिस्ता से बोलो सब सुन रहे हैं हाँ बोलिए माननीय सदस्य बोलिए आप भी माननीय सदस्य माननीय सदस्य को बोलने
दें। This is just a ploy to interrupt my speech.
No interrupt.
Please, sir, please keep the house in order, sir. I beg you. I beseech you, sir. Please keep the house in order. Right? Because they have.
आप उधर मत करो माननीय सदस्य
इधर। I am looking at you, sir. Sir, I am looking, but you must keep them quiet.
No, इधर।
Please keep the house in order. Please keep the house in order. I have got 22 minutes. I will speak. Like I said, the truth is the truth.
फिर माननीय सदस्य
minority of one. And in times of deceit, speaking the truth is a revolutionary act.
माननीय सदस्य प्लीज बैठ जाएं। माननीय सदस्य पहली बार चुनकर आई हैं। आप सब माननीय सदस्य शांति से उनकी बात को सुने और माननीय सदस्य आपसे भी आग्रह है आप आसन के माध्यम से अपनी बात को कहें।
सर आई स्पोक ओनली थ्रू द बिफोर दिस मैडम चेयरपर्सन नाउ आई एम स्पीकिंग ओनली थ्रू आई एम फॉलोइंग पार्लियामेंट्री प्रोसीडियर इट इज अनफॉर्चुनेट दैट द ट्रेजरी इट इज अनफॉर्चुनेट दैट द ट्रेजरी ब्रांचेस सी इट फिट टू डिस्टर्ब मी एंड आई विल टेक एन एक्स्ट्रा 3 मिनट्स आई एम टेलिंग यू थैंक यू हमने सोच लिया और हम विरोध वापस नहीं लेंगे आई विल स्टैंड हियर इन दिस हॉलो चेंबर एंड आई विल स्पेल आउट माय ऑपोजिशन सर 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 आई विल स्टैंड हियर इन दिस हॉलो
माननीय सदस्य मैं देख लूंगा प्लीज मैं देख लूंगा माननीय सदस्य प्लीज मैं देख लूंगा माननीय सदस्य मैं देख लूंगा माननीय सदस्य प्लीज माननीय सदस्य प्लीज बोलने दे माननीय सदस्य
आई विल स्पेल आउट माय ऑपोजिशन टू दिस बिल
माननीय सदस्य इधर
आई विल स्पेल आउट माय ऑपोजिशन नॉट जस्ट टू दिस बिल नॉट जस्ट टू द ट्रेजरी बंचेस बट टू ऑल द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया हु मे बी लिसनिंग दिस कंट्री स्टिल हैज सर प्लीज कीप द हाउस इन ऑर्डर आई
माननीय सदस्य आप आपका समय खत्म हो गया मैं एक्स्ट्रा समय दे रहा हूँ
आई विल कीप स्पीकिंग सर दे आर डिस्टर्बिंग मी आई अर्ज यू टू बी फेयर दिस कंट्री स्टिल हैज पीपल दैट अप्रिशिएट नुआंस इट स्टिल हैज पीपल हु हैव नॉट डीजेनरेटेड इनटू दिस माइंडलेस वर्ल्ड ऑफ ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट वेयर ईदर वी कैन ओनली बी प्रो गवर्नमेंट और वी कैन बी एंटी कंट्री वी हैव नॉट ऑल ऑफ इंडिया डज नॉट बिलीव दिस इवन इफ मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस हाउस में All of India does not believe this. So it is possible to stay here, to stand here and be anti-government and still be pro-India. And that's the space that I seek to represent today. Let me now go through this bill and point out what is so wrong with it. I will try and make it as simple as possible without the legalese. So ordinary citizens may understand this because this is not just a bill for lawyers. This is not just a bill for police people. This is a bill that may affect you and me tomorrow. So we must be able to speak in a way that ordinary people must be able to understand.
ये आतंकवादियों पे इफेक्ट डालेगा आप पे नहीं डालेगा
मानो सुनो। Concentrate. नहीं, according to this amendment, honourable speaker. According to this amendment, honourable speaker. That is just the point. You have hit the nail on the head. You have hit the nail on the head, Honorable Speaker. This bill seeks to do one thing. One is to designate individuals as terrorists without due process. So, kal hume bhi kar sakte hain. Isiliye hum bol rahe. That is exactly what this bill is trying to do. The second thing, it is trying to do two things. There are two amendments that are very worrying. There, I would urge you to please stop them from heckling, Mr. Speaker, sir. There are two amendments here which are extremely worrying. I will go through both of them. The first is the amendment which is to clause 5, section 25, which enables the NIA to be able to go into any state and to arrest and seize and search properties without the permission of the state's DGP or even without the knowledge of the state's DGP. Now this is completely against the federal structure of our country because if you see in list 1, you are trying to give the NIA policing powers under ICC and under other special acts. The NIA is not an agency that is in list 1. It is in list 2 that the powers of policing are vested with the state. So in this case, the only agency which is on list 1 is the Central Bureau of Investigation and the Central Bureau of Inquiry. Now in this case, the State High Court of Assam has even struck down the constitutional validity of even the CBI. That is a stay order case pending in the Supreme Court. So in this case where the NIA itself is under a cloud, you are giving it more policing powers. Even the CBI, when they go in to investigate, they work with the state police. We are a federal structure. States have a certain degree of sovereignty. In this case, if the DGP is not even aware of this and the NIA come in, this is a power which is completely goes against the grain of the Constitution. There have been the second point, which is the most dangerous amendment, is clause 5, section 35. Exactly what you referred to. What you are doing is you are seeking to designate individuals as terrorists in addition to the existing terrorist organization. In section 35, you are creating a whole different test of who is a terrorist. Individuals involved in terrorism, or he promotes or encourages terrorism. Now, section, the current UAPA in its current form already allows you to take all action possible for individuals that are involved in terrorism. You have section 16, which gives you the death penalty and life imprisonment. You have section 38 to 48, which criminalizes membership, support, and raising funds. So there is no need to designate individuals without due process. You have set out in this section 36 a process for denotification. But there is no process for notification. You are talking about the UN Security Council saying in the statement of objects and reasons that we have to be in line with international obligations. The UN Security Council Resolution 1373 lays out very clearly what is the process for freezing funds. In this case, there is nothing laid out. There is no process. It's not even following law procedure. Forget about due process. So any government in India which has taken away the safeguards for life and liberty that the Constitution has given to us, no government has been able to survive without paying a heavy price. You yourself have got somebody who has come in elected, and I respect the person who has come in elected as an Honourable Member of Parliament, who is a terror accused under NIA. You say it was political targeting. Fine, I can believe it may be political targeting, but you are doing the same thing that tomorrow may be targeting somebody else. So, लगेगी आग, लगेगी आग, सदस्य तो आएंगे घर के ही जद में, लगेगी आग तो आएंगे घर के ही जद में,
श्री सुनील कुमार
थोड़ी है. So I urge you, Mr. Speaker, I urge you through you to tell the Honourable Minister to please withdraw this bill. This is anti-federalism, it is anti-constitutional, and it's anti-people. It is a very dangerous bill. I urge you, please take it back. Thank you.
Adhyaksh Mahoday,
Sunil Kumar Pintu ji.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, आज जो ये बिल आया है, इसके पक्ष में बोलने के लिए मैं खड़ा हुआ हूं. महोदय, पिछले पांच साल में माननीय प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के नेतृत्व की जो सरकार देश में जो आतंकवाद पर नकेल कसने का काम किया, वो एक प्रशंसनीय है. पहले आतंकवाद, आज के पांच साल से पहले राज्यों के तक में पहुंच रहे थे.